Scarier than banjos in the woods is the moans of the undead followed by banjos in the woods. Fortunately, as everybody knows, zombies can't swim. That's why any good survivor buys some kayaks ahead of time. Why kayaks? But why kayaks, you ask? That's easy. Shallow draft, no noise, human powered. You can launch and land them anywhere. They float stupid shallow. Zombie turtle. And cargo capacity. Stealth in, stealth out. Oh nay, you pedal boat user, you. Everybody knows we can go shallower in paddle than you can in pedal. Oh, Boomy, you don't want the dolphins to come out and chase you in the shallow water, do you? Anybody spending time in the swamps, marshes, bogs, anywhere else knows you can't run through skinny water. You sink up to your knees. At that point, you reach back to your handy-dandy rod holders, warhammer, bearded axe, improvised spear, or just reach down to your seat, customized sheath, for the brain sticker. The options are limitless. The shallow water is a trap for the zombies.
But my pedal boat weighs twice as much and costs twice as much and has the name of a famous sailboat company. It must be better than your traditional pedal boats.
Now, let's be honest here. Twice as heavy is a real thing. It's twice as heavy. Twice as heavy to load, twice as heavy to move, twice as heavy to unload. Things you'll never do with a pedal boat. Move around, stand up, walk, back, twirl, portage. Load on the car, unload from the car, take to the backyard. These are things we do in the real world. And when things go bad, you're gonna be doing them by yourself. This is my newest baby though, Profish GT. It's a fat, short boat that paddles like a fast boat. Personally, don't understand how, but they did the trick awesome. It's extremely nimble for these small waters. Turn around, get out, go someplace else. Workhorse stability, load it down with gear, great for river fishing, great for river treks, 3-day trips down the river. This is the way to go. The same thing that makes it good for that would make this great for end of the world situation. You're tired of the up close and personal work. You don't want to use knife, axe, hammer, etc. You want to reach out and touch something with high capacity. Well, Profish GT offers you that option. Normally we have our tackle, our gear, our camera, our video gear in here. We unhook it, we carry it to the car, we drop it back in, snap it back in, everything's wonderful and handy dandy. But in the end of the world situation, this tackle pod turns into a tackle pod.
That's right, this handy dandy tackle pod becomes a tactical pod. Remove the elastic strap, open the door. Remove tool from compartment. Insert magazine, charge, release. 30 rounds of reach out and touch you for every zombie. If you don't like that, we also have 40 rounders.
Let's say you want to be more proactive. You want to go out and hunt down the zombie threat. Well, the tackle pod is still here for you. AR-15 lower. AR-15 upper with hollow sight. M4.
Pada! 40 rounds of reach out and touch you, zombie killing potential.
That just might work for normal hunting too, not just zombies.
No kidding, Skippy. All throughout the South waterways are full of pigs, deer, etc. Ready for the taking. This right here is actually my favorite pig gun. Paddle out, shoot a pig, throw it in the back of the kayak, paddle back to the Jeep, drive home, pull pork for days. I could even feed about half my block off of one pig. So yeah, it does apply.
How much fuel you got in that glitter boat? What, a day's worth? Then what are you gonna do? Everybody knows zombies attract to the noise. You're gonna pull up that fuel station, and they'll be circling that pump waiting for you to come out. Then what you gonna do?